Hello everyone, I'm Rick Kinley. I'm the Executive Director of Acquisitions here at Rock Island Auction Company. And today we're gonna talk to you about a few firearms from WW Greener that are gonna be in our December premiere sale, which is December 4th, 5th, and 6th, with a full day preview on December 3rd. So as I said, these are some firearms from WW Greener. All these are manufactured by WW Greener. And as any of you that have followed our auctions are probably aware, we've been selling for the last few auctions the Malcom King collection out of England. And this is really the first kind of gathering of his Greener shotguns, his Greener guns that we're going to have coming up in this December auction. And this is probably one of the best assemblages of Greener guns at auction in the country, probably in the last 50 or 60 years. So just a very, very good opportunity for those of you that are into any of the Greener firearms here again at this December premiere sale. So for those of you that may not be familiar with WW Greener, they're a very well-known maker, still making firearms today in Birmingham, England. So WW Greener really got his start from his father. His father, William Greener, was making guns, and then he kind of took over the business. And WW Greener is probably the more familiar one that people are familiar with today. But both him and his father were inventors. They were authors. They're very well known for many of their books that they wrote on firearms and different inventions that they may have had. Probably the most famous one is WW Greener, The Gun and Its Development, which is certainly a must-have for anybody that's interested in English firearms. So, but again, obviously, he's known best for making firearms, and these are some of the best examples that we've ever had come through here. So the first one that we're going to start out with here is a 8-bore. It's a hammer shotgun, and there's a couple of reasons that we're going to start with this. It's certainly, we're not necessarily saving the best for last, because this is one of the best shotguns in the whole group for a number of reasons. But again, this is going to be one of his earlier guns that he made, but it has his patented treble wedge fast, or kind of what we, known to be called the Greener cross bolt, which is basically just using a large bolt that goes through a rib extension. Very, very famously known for that. And like I said, this is a very early example of it. It's actually etched on the rib, treble grip fast, patented. So it's just a very early Greener, but the main thing that sets this gun apart is actually the silver inlays that are done on it. Just from the side, you'll see just a little arrow on the drop points here. That's actually pure silver. But then when we look at the trigger guard, you can see the trigger guard has silver hallmarks in it, which, any of the English silver would have to have the hallmarks. But you can see it there. The grip cap is also made of silver, and then also the butt plate is entirely made of silver. Again, you see your hallmarks here. It's all engraved, all checkered, just absolutely beautiful. And what makes that unique is you just don't see a lot of silver inlays, particularly for the hardware on a shotgun like this. We see silver inlays into the action sometimes, in the engraving, but this is actually, silver made for the hardware. And this was kind of common more in like your flintlock eras, maybe even in some of the percussion eras, but by this time, that really wasn't seen. But so very, very unique. And this was purportedly made for one of the Indian Maharajas, which, obviously they're very well known for their very high-end, very flamboyant decorations on any of their shotguns or any of their guns. So that would kind of fit, but a very, very unique gun. I've never seen another one like this that has the silver furniture. So just very cool, very unique. So on to the next one here. And as we go through, you're going to see a bunch of the different types of firearms that Greener made. Again, he was an inventor. He was known for a lot of different inventions that we still use today. In firearms, but this is several different types of firearms that he would make. Obviously, this one's a rotary underlever, a hammer gun, and then here we have a side lock, which is something he wasn't as known for. He was more known for his Bock locks, the Facile Princeps actions, but this is actually a beautiful, best quality side lock, and this is a 10-bore, And you can see just the quality of the gun itself, but then also the engraving. You have some really beautiful panel scenes of here we've got a setter with pheasants and two different panel scenes on the engraving. The bottom just has some ducks on the bottom here. And then on the left plate, we've got more ducks with another setter and two different panels. We can see the carved fences as well. So again, this is not something that you normally would see on greeners. You don't normally think of greeners and think of best quality side locks with panel scene engraving like this, but that's exactly what this is. And so again, a very unique greener shotgun in just exceptional condition. So we go from the shotguns, and once again, I mean, really that's what Greener was known for, was his shotguns. A lot of his patents had to do with shotguns, but he also made different rifles. So this one up front here, I mean, actually it's technically a shotgun, but as you can see, it has rifled sights on it. So this would have been known as a ball gun, and essentially it was a shotgun that's meant to shoot solid slugs out of it. And really the idea behind that is for a lot of your dangerous game. I mean, it could be multi-purpose, but for the most part, this was going to shoot large slugs at dangerous game. But this is a very, very high quality one. This is marked actually as a F Royal grade. I mean, you need a PhD to figure out all the different grades that Greener made, but essentially an F Royal was one of their higher grades at a particular time. And you can see going through this, it certainly was a high quality gun. You can see the crown, the gold inlaid crown on the top lever as well, indicating the royal grade. But this was more than likely would have been made for the Indian market, you know, whether it was one of the Maharajas or just somebody in India. But as we go through the engraving, you'll kind of see why that's most likely not only being a dangerous game ball gun, but also just the engraving itself. So you can see here on the left side we have a tiger, which obviously would have been popular Indian game at the time when this was made. And then on the bottom, I'm not as up on my Asian deer, but the two different types of Asian deer on the bottom of the action, and then on the trigger guard itself. And then on the right side, something that most people probably more think of with African game, but also at this time period, people would have thought it with Indian game is a leopard on the right side here as well. So, and then also a really cool part about this gun is as you can see on the initial shield, you can see this is an enameled on the shield here, so you got these bright colors. I don't know if we found out for sure whose shield this might be, but you know, certainly it's got a crown and the enamel on it, so it's very cool, I believe. But again, this is just something very unique. We don't see a lot of these 10 gauge rifled sight ball guns like this. We have the case with it as well, and it actually listed as a 10 bore smooth shotgun with the rifled sights. So it's again just a very, very cool WW Greener shotgun that we have coming up in this auction. And then we go from that gun to an actual double rifle here, which again, this is a Facile Princeps action, which was again an action that Greener was known for. Very similar to a box lock, but they actually got into some kind of some legal arguments, basically separating the Facile Princeps action from a box lock. So that is what this is. This one's in 450, 400 Black Powder Express. This would have been more of a medium game type rifle, probably for England or throughout Europe. But and again, same thing. We got some fantastic game scene engraving on it. Looks like we have a boar here on the left, a stag on the bottom, a roe deer on the trigger guard. Then we have another stag here on the right side of the action with the setter's head there on the front part. It looks like there actually was a hound's head as well with the boar. And this one is actually, again, I kind of talked earlier about you need a PhD to figure out the different grades. This one is listed as a grade 403, which is quite a bit different than a lot of their other grades, but you can certainly tell this is a very high quality double rifle with beautiful game scene engraving, the Greener style safety that you see. Again, it's It's kind of one of those things that you you see on a lot of the different greeners, and certainly calls out as a greener. And then once again, the treble wedge fast, or the greener crossbolt, as it's very commonly known. So, but again, these are just four of the greener guns that we have coming up in this December premiere sale as part of the Malcom King collection. And there's some other great collectors that we have with greeners in this auction. But this is your opportunity if you're a greener collector, if you're into high quality English double guns, this is your chance. Like I said, this is probably one of the best groupings of greener guns to ever come up at auction in the last 50, 60 years. And again, they're going to be in our premier auction on December 4th, 5th, and 6th with the full day preview on December 3rd. You can go to our website. The catalog is up right now, www.rockislandauction.com, and see more photos and more in-depth descriptions on all these guns, as well as all the other items we have coming up in that sale. Once again, it's on December 4th, 5th, and 6th with a full day preview on December 3rd.